Welcome to another episode of Extended Play, the Let's Play by Sim Nation. And we're about to hit a milestone. You like my road? It's kind of fancy. It's really fancy. It's Sim Nation fancy. Alright, let's hit that milestone. We're like, and oh, 494. Now, 3, 2, 1. Now. All right, now. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Look at the fireworks. You will hear the sound effect in like 30 seconds. I kid you not. You will hear it in 30 seconds. So we got a lot of money. Now we can build a. Oh no! Wait, this is the metro. I wanted the fucking train. Well, screw you. Screw you badly. I guess we could put one of these down anyways. I don't know where the smartest location for this would be, but I'm guessing somewhere around here, far from, well, this. As you can see, my traffic is getting denser because of me using the hard mode. No, not really the hard mode. The reality check with no teletransportation, clearly. And I have to expand this. And cars moving at real speeds. Right, let's just go all the way here. Alright, you can go fast all the way here, and then, you know, because this is pretty much where cars go in and out. So we're gonna make it a 3-lane, and then, you know, back to 2, because it looks pretty. So yeah, okay, no, I guess we could use this. This would help with the traffic anyways. I mean, I'd much rather have them use that. So, let's see, where would you put this? If you were a bus station, where would you want to live? Actually, wait, can I incinerate now? I wanted to incinerate garbage. Oh, there we go. That is something I wanted to do. So that is something that we're definitely gonna do. We're gonna put it right there, and we're gonna start to empty this. And where, you may ask? Well, to the incinerator. I want to make sure it works. There we go. And now it will start emptying, and hopefully here. There we go. So, well, I guess we could put the bus station somewhere around here. I don't want to screw up, guys. Screwing up in this mode is too tough. Too tough for me. We are gonna go straight. No, actually. Yeah, straight? What is that? We're gonna go this way. And then we're gonna go straight. Fancy. Fancy straight. Then gonna lay down the bus station somewhere around here, and hopefully this doesn't kill us. And time to lay down our first route in the city. So we're gonna open up. Oh damn, really? You're fine, don't complain. All right, so we're gonna open up with let's see, I love to start. Bus is going this way. Yeah, sure, why not. We're gonna open up here, and we're gonna go all the way here. And can we go back immediately? No, we're gonna actually take all the way around. I said somebody that lane bus system is really stupid in this game. Somebody saying like just the game wasn't good at all. Yeah, a hater if you may. There was a lot of truth in what he said, and others he was clearly just pissed and was inventing stuff like the transportation here is so simple. You just lay down stops and that's it. Like, this is the first game, first city builder I play that actually does this. So like, others were even simpler than this. I don't know what kind of complexity are you looking for, man. But it was on the Paradox forums, by the way. It's not Reddit or stuff like that. Oh, they would have killed the guy on Reddit. Reddit is such like a self-managed place. It's amazing. To the extent you can't even share stuff, which is that is kind of silly, but you know. I mean, I want to share simulation stuff, and of course they go like, "Well, you cannot share stuff that are yours." Damn it. You can only share stuff that aren't. But I like my stuff. Oh no, I don't want to put it here. I mean, I do like my stuff. Why? I mean, I'm not gonna promote somebody else. I know the idea is to, you know. What a terrible idea, going through these houses. All right, whatever. No, at least we're taking it off the highways. We're gonna go this way, so they can go to work. Using this method, it's transportation, and then we're gonna make a stop here, and then we're gonna come. We're gonna come here. Actually, we wanna come here, and then we wanna come here. Then we wanna come here, and then we wanna go back. And we wanna come here. And here. And then we wanna cross the bridge. Oh, that's a big road. Ah, yeah, whatever. It is quite a big journey. But I love this. I love this feature of the game, and I'm so happy they put this in. Because I think it adds a lot of personality to how the transportation works in your city, pretty much. Instead of being like dull, like, well, buses need to go to places, so you just like, okay, actually, wait, in SimCity, I'm not giving SimCity enough credit here, because you did have to lay down the bus stops instead of being automatic. It just, of course, you know, you didn't have this level of detail, but it was there. There was definitely detail on SimCity. That's like the wrong play. Well, no, I guess that's kind of fine. All right, there we go, complete line. And I want to see those buses getting on that. Yes, yes, hello. There's so many buses going everywhere. All right, so we're gonna be following our bus, because guys, I want to follow buses. I love to follow buses. It's my thing. Did I mention that I realized why this mode is laggier than this? It's because this one needs to render the whole height of the screen. This doesn't. That's why they make it opaque. Anyways, I think I said it before. But actually, we're gonna stay in this mode. Let's see. Yeah, we're not in our path yet. Okay, I think now we officially are. I don't know if that was the starting point, but okay, that works with me. There we go. Oh yes. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Chill. Okay, guys. There's room for everybody. Okay. That's kind of in a rush. Okay. I think that they come out like a little bit too often, don't they? I know I have the mod to make things go slower, so you know that definitely helping to get them, well, pretty much like in a straight row. Okay, some are stopped, thankfully, to my terrible system. Is there a stop there? I don't see. Ah, yeah, there is. But yeah, let's just follow the guy. 39% complete, or full, sorry. Oh yeah, this is one of the parts that I love. I think I'm just following this. Like, let me enjoy the stuff that I like. Follow. I need to drink some water. Not a lot of saying random stuff make you thirsty. Aww. Look at all the people. I don't know for which bus they're waiting for, because to be honest, it doesn't go anywhere else. This is it. This is literally it. Man, I don't know if it was a good idea to put this on a regular road. I may have to destroy all these buildings eventually. This is more like in a North American kind of building, isn't it? That one right there. Yeah. Oh, Professor Oak! Professor Oak! exclamation mark. Oh man. But yeah, I kind of like the city, this city building game that, okay, hold on. I saw this before and I never fixed it. That, you know, you're following this guy, picking up people, and you still see on the distance, you know, the rest of your city, building burning, and all your you know, power plants. I love that. I love the feeling of space. I guess that is really what is so attractive to me in this game. Like, if you would remove all the space that you have in City Skylines, SimCity is clearly way better. Like, this is one of the main things that make the game good. One of the main things that probably, or for most people, make it way better than SimCity. You know, when somebody says better, it's on one's taste and opinion. There's no absolutely better. Depending on what you're comparing on, you can make an objective decision of something being better or not, right? You can say, well, this one clearly has a better transportation system than SimCity, right? But SimCity clearly looked more beautiful. You could maybe say that you don't like the art style, but it was clearly more beautiful regardless of the art style. Really, guys, there are two more lanes here. Come on. I said on my review, you are smart. I mean, not super smart, I added later, but you were smart. Don't make me shove it back into my mouth by doing this. Come on, take this lane. Are you really gonna turn left? Where are you gonna go? Are you gonna turn left? That's why I was gonna turn left, son of them. Maybe I should make it so that if it's going to turn left, that is a good thing. You can totally analyze this. Maybe I could do it so that if you're gonna turn left, right, you don't go here and instead you go straight, right? So maybe this road that was kind of fancy, we're gonna make it fancier. And what we're gonna do is actually have buses will pretty much take this road. I will force them this way, right? So that they go straight here, right? And ignore all this traffic. I kind of like that. I kind of like that a lot. And that is a good thing, that you can pretty much stop, you know, fix something and then continue. Okay, the chosen one, because you're the chosen one. I mean, if I clearly chose you instead of like others. This is the first bus. First city bus. Actually, this is the first one. Yeah. Even though these ones are clearly more ahead of me. No, they're not ahead. They're doing the other part. I'm confused now. Anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, so you cannot say that something is absolute better than something else, because it depends on what is important to you. If for you graphics are important, one game is going to be better than other if it has better graphics, right? So it's really relative. What you can do is objectively compare a specific feature and then decide if it's better or not. Now, aesthetics, this game has acceptable. It has good aesthetics. Sorry, yeah, it has good aesthetics. Aesthetics basically, it has nothing to do with graphics. You can have great aesthetics on 8-bit color palette and 640 by 480 resolution, and you can still have great aesthetics. It basically means how beautiful and rich the images. Not rich. How beautiful the images are, the shapes and the colors and so on, regardless of the technology that you're using. And then there's graphic fidelity or graphic quality, which would mean, you know, how detailed you can make things, or the texture quality and the amount of polygons you're drawing and the special effects that you're drawing on top, stuff like that. Oh, I think this is when we take this sort of like thing that goes around. And then we go that way. Cool. Now we're gonna cross the bridge. Oh, I totally wanna do that. Is my city fine on the other side? Yeah. Anyway. You're not the first city bus. You're the second city bus. Actually, wait. Third. And the other one will just, you know, that. Anyways, I wonder if I can ever find this bus again. I should try to just change the name of all of them and see if eventually like they hold them or not. Anyway, oh, now we're going. Well, okay, oof, the camera is not good. All right, we're gonna do this. Oof, it's not good either. Okay, we're gonna take the side. There we go. Yay! Wow, it takes a long while to go all the way around the... Oof, this is like terrible. Ramps are not good. Should have thought of that. Yep, they're not good. Actually, I don't know why I did that. It has to go through the other lane. Well, it sort of gives you an idea. Alright, so people were waiting here. There's quite a few people. Too bad you cannot click the bus stop. It'd be quite nice to be able to see how many people are waiting here, but... Or you can count them. I mean, if you have time. I mean, I have time to follow a bus, but not time to really click them. Each one will not count. I do enjoy this. I do enjoy this, and I can't wait to do it with the trains as well. Especially because this city, at least everything like the simulation is one-on-one. Right? What you see is what you get. Anyways, talking about which, speaking of which, there is something that SimCity did that I kind of loved. The glass box simulation. The fact that there were robberies happening and robbers had to exist. They would become robbers because they wouldn't have money. Like, there was a reason, a cause for things. Sims would get sick out of pollution. Pollution, I don't even know what it does here. It lowers health statistically, but that is, hey, there is no... Shoot. There is no such thing as, you know... Sims getting sick and taking that sickness back to the city. I kind of keep saying that stuff, but... You know, so in that term, SimCity is better. But if you want to say which of the two is generally better, it's completely up to you. For you, it could be City Skylines, it could be the SimCity, SimCity 4, 3000. Some people said the best one until City Skylines came out was SimCity 2000. I'm not going to argue with them. For me, that is like the most stupid thing ever, but I'm not going to argue with them. And for some, I am sure that Cities XL is the best game. I'm definitely not going to argue with them. So yeah, anyways. I love to just follow a bus around and seeing what works and what doesn't. Also, I like to fix things on the way. This game has a lot of popping with the trees, like going through different quality. They don't have that thing of SimCity. SimCity, like, I watched Ocean Quigley video on how they did art for SimCity. What a beautiful piece of video. I still want to talk to about it, and I don't have time. I'm going on vacations. You're probably watching this. I'm already on vacations. I'm pre-recording this, so you have a little me to taste while I am away. But what a beautiful video, just explaining all the techniques they did to pack all that level of detail and make it run well fast, right? They explained the technique that I kept talking to you guys about, like how they made trees. Trees are basically like a plane. They're like an always facing plane, like a plane that is always facing you, right? Even if they look like they have depth, yeah, the trees, they're actually plain, and they sort of like pre-render them in a buffer, and then they just paint it there. It's quite impressive, all the techniques that they use to make SimCity look that good. And the techniques to make the interiors, you know how you can kind of see inside buildings and see like there is some space? Beautiful. In here, I mean, they don't have that technology, so everything is 100% reflective. You can see like every single thing is 100% reflective, and it's okay. You know, that smaller budget. But anyways, yeah, we'll be forever comparing games. I like to do that. That is a good way, I think, to define what's good and what isn't about games. And you know, each one brings something different to the table, so you get to compare them. That's the beauty of it. Anyways, that is all the time I got for now. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you maybe in a more interactive experience next time. Oh, this is the most satisfying thing ever. We are God in SimCity 4. Wow, that was loud. Oh, you're gonna eat that, huh? You're gonna eat it. I see. What? Nothing. Okay.
And now she is tossing that salad with her... Stop sticking your finger in your ear! Alright, she's tossing the salad with her earwax.
It does.
It does really well.
Okay.
Oh, they're coming for you, Pablo! Shit! Run!
Oh, yeah. These road trips, man, are killing me. Anyway, let me know whenever we are recording.
Hi, and welcome to another episode of Extended Play. I'm your host, this is Stuart, and that is a fancy, fancy sign. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.
I want to follow buses. I love to follow buses. It's my thing.
Did I mention that I realized why this mode is laggier than this? It's because this one needs to render the whole height of the screen. This doesn't. That's why they make it opaque. Anyways, I think I said it before then. Actually, we're gonna stay in this mode. Let's see. Yeah. We're not in our path yet. Okay, I think now we officially are. I don't know if that was the starting point, but okay, that works with me. There we go. Oh, yes. Okay, okay. Yeah, okay, okay. Chill. Okay, guys, there's room for everybody. Okay. Okay, that's kind of in a rush. Okay, okay. I think that they come out like a little bit too often, don't they? I know I have the mod to make things go slower, so you know that. Definitely helping to get them. Well, pretty much like in a straight row. Okay, some are stopped, thankfully, my terrible system. Is there a stop there? I don't see. Ah, yeah, there is. But yeah, let's just follow the guy. 39% complete. Or full, sorry. This is one of the parts that I love, I think. Just following this. Like, let me enjoy the stuff that I like. Follow. I need to drink some water. Not a lot of saying random stuff make you thirsty.
Oh,
look at all the people. I don't know for which bus they're waiting for, because to be honest, it doesn't go anywhere else. This is it. This is literally it. Man, I don't know if it was a good idea to put this on a regular road. I may have to destroy all these buildings eventually. This is more like a North American kind of building, isn't it? That one right there. Yeah. Oh, Professor Oak! Professor Oak! exclamation mark. Oh man. But yeah, I kind of like the city, this city building game that, okay, hold on. I saw this before and I never fixed it. That, you know, you're following this guy, picking up people, and you still see on the distance, you know, the rest of your city, a building burning and all your, you know, power plants. I love that. I love the feeling of space. I guess that is really what is so attractive to me in this game. Like, if you would remove all the space that you have in City Skylines, SimCity is clearly way better. Like, this is one of the main things that make the game good. One of the main things that probably, or for most people, make it way better than SimCity. You know, when somebody says better, it's on one's taste and opinion. There's no absolute better. Depending on what you're comparing on, you can make an objective decision of something being better or not, right? You can say, well, this one clearly has a better transportation system than SimCity, right? But SimCity clearly looked more beautiful. You could maybe say that you don't like the art style, but it was clearly more beautiful regardless of the art style. Really, guys, there are two more lanes here. Come on. I said on my review, you are smart. I mean, not super smart, I added later, but you were smart. Don't make me shove it back into my mouth by doing this. Come on, take this lane. Are you really gonna turn left? Where are you gonna go? Are you gonna turn left? That's why I was gonna turn left, son of them. Maybe I should make it so that if it's going to turn left, that is a good thing. You can totally analyze this. Maybe I could do it so that if you are gonna turn left, right? You don't go here, and instead you go straight, right? So maybe this road that was kind of fancy, we're gonna make it fancier, and what we're gonna do is actually have buses will pretty much take this road. I will force them this way, right? So that they go straight here, right? And ignore all this traffic. Yeah, I kind of like that. I kind of like that a lot. And that is a good thing, that you can pretty much stop, you know, fix something and then continue. Okay, the chosen one, because you're the chosen one. I mean, if I clearly chose you instead of like others. This is the first boss. First city boss. Actually, this is the first one. Yeah. Even though these ones are clearly more ahead of me. Oh, no, they're not ahead. They're doing the other part. Oh no, wait. Oh, I'm confused now. Anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, so you cannot say that something is absolute better than something else, because it depends on what is important to you. If for you graphics are important, one game is going to be better than other if it has better graphics, right? So it's really relative. What you can do is objectively compare a specific feature and then decide if it's better or not. Now, aesthetics, this game has acceptable. It has good aesthetics. Sorry, yeah, it has good aesthetics. Aesthetics basically, it has nothing to do with graphics. You can have great aesthetics on 8-bit color palette and 640 by 480 resolution, and you can still have great aesthetics. It basically means how beautiful and rich the images. Not rich. How beautiful the images are, the shapes and the colors and so on, regardless of the technology that you're using. And then there's graphic fidelity or graphic quality. Open up with, let's see, I love to start. Bus is going this way. Yeah, sure, why not? We're gonna open up here and we're gonna go all the way here. And can we go back immediately? No. We're gonna actually take all the way around. I see somebody that lane bus system is really stupid in this game. Somebody saying like just the game wasn't good at all. Yeah, a hater if you may. There was a lot of truth in what he said, and others he was clearly just pissed and was inventing stuff like the transportation here is so simple. You just lay down stops and that's it. Like, this is the first game, first city builder I played that actually does this. So, like, others were even simpler than this. I don't know what kind of complexity are you looking for, man, but it was on the Paradox forums, by the way. It's not Reddit or stuff like that. Oh, they would have killed the guy on Reddit. Reddit is such, like, a self-managed place. It's amazing. To the extent... you can even share stuff, which is that is kind of silly, but you know. I mean, I want to share simulation stuff, and of course, they go like, well, you cannot share stuff that are yours. Damn it. You can only share stuff that aren't. But I like my stuff. Oh, no, I didn't want to put it here. I do like my stuff. Why? I mean, I'm not going to promote somebody else. I know the idea is to, you know. What a terrible idea, going through these houses. All right, whatever. No, at least we're taking it off the highways. We're gonna go this way, so they can go to work using this method. It's transportation, and then we're gonna make a stop here, and then we're gonna come. We're gonna come here. Actually, we wanna come here, and then we wanna come here. Then we want to come here, and then we want to go back. And we want to come here. And here. And then we want to cross the bridge. That's a big road. Whatever. It is quite a big journey. But I love this. I love this feature of the game, and I'm so happy they put this in, because I think it adds a lot of personality to how the transportation works in your city, pretty much. Instead of being like dull, like, well, buses need to go to places, so you just like, okay, actually, wait, in SimCity, I'm not giving SimCity enough credit here, because you did have to lay down the bus stops instead of being automatic. It just, of course, you know, you didn't have this level of detail, but it was there. There was definitely detail on SimCity. That's like the rumbling. I guess that's kind of fine. All right, there we go, complete line. And I want to see those buses getting on that. Hello. There's so many buses going everywhere. All right, so we're going to be following our bus, because guys, which would mean, you know, how detailed you can make things, or the texture quality and the amount of polygons you're drawing and the special effects that you're drawing on top, stuff like that. Oh, I think this is when we take this sort of like thing that goes around. And then we go that way. Cool. Now we're gonna cross the bridge. Oh, I totally wanna do that. Is my city fine on the other side? Yeah. Anyway. You're not the first city bus. You're the second city bus. Actually, wait. Third. And the other one will just, you know, that. Anyways, I wonder if I can ever find this bus again. I should try to just change the name of all of them and see if eventually like they hold them or not. Anyway, oh, now we're going. Well, okay, oof, the camera is not good. All right, we're gonna do this. Oof, it's not good either. Okay, we're gonna take the side. There we go. Yay! Wow, it takes a long while to go all the way around. Oof, this is like terrible. Ramps are not good. Should have thought of that. Yep, they're not good. Actually, I don't know why I did that. It has to go through the other lane. Well, it sort of gives you an idea. All right, so people were waiting here. There's quite a few people. Too bad you cannot click the bus stop. It'd be quite nice to be able to see how many people are waiting here, but... Or you can count them. I mean, if you have time. I mean, I have time to follow a bus, but not time to really click them. Each one will not count. I do enjoy this. I do enjoy this, and I can't wait to do it with the trains as well. Especially because this city, at least everything like the simulation is 101, right? What you see is what you get. Anyways, speaking of which, there is something that SimCity did that I kind of loved. The glass simulation. The fact that there were robberies happening, and robbers had to exist, they would become robbers because they wouldn't have money. Like, there was a reason, a cause for things. Sims would get sick out of pollution. I don't even know what it does here. It lowers health statistically, but that is it. There is no such thing as, you know. Sims getting sick and taking that sickness back to the city. I kind of keep saying that stuff, but. You know, so in that term, SimCity is better, but if you want to say which of the two is generally better, it's completely up to you. For you, it could be City Skylines, it could be the SimCity, SimCity 4, 3000. Some people said the best one until City Skylines came out was SimCity 2000. I'm not gonna argue with them. For me, that is like the most stupid thing ever, but I'm not gonna argue with them. And for some, I am sure that Cities XL is the best game. I'm definitely not gonna argue with them. Anyways, I love to just follow a bus around and seeing what works and what doesn't. Also, I like to fix things on the way. This game has a lot of popping with the trees, like the.
Welcome to another episode of Extended Play, the Let's Play by Sim Nation. And we're about to hit a milestone. You like my road? It's kind of fancy. It's really fancy. It's Sim Nation fancy. All right, let's hit that milestone. Or like
And... oh, 494. Now, now, 3, 2, 1. Now! Alright, now! Thank you everyone, thank you. Thank you. Look at the fireworks. You will hear the sound effect in like 30 seconds. I kid you not. You will hear it in 30 seconds. So we got a lot of money, now we can build a... oh no, wait, this is the metro, I wanted the fucking train. Well, screw you. Screw you badly. I guess we could put one of these down anyways. I don't know where the smartest location for this would be, but I'm guessing somewhere around here, far from, well, this. As you can see, my traffic is getting denser because of me using the hard mode. No, not really the hard mode. The reality check with no teletransportation, clearly. And I have to expand this. And cars moving at real speeds. Right, let's just go all the way here. All right, you can go fast all the way here, and then, you know, because this is pretty much where cars go in and out. So we're gonna make it a 3-lane, and then, you know, back to 2, because it looks pretty. So yeah, okay, no, I guess we could use this. This would help with the traffic anyways. I mean, I'd much rather have them use that. So, let's see, where would you put this? If you were a bus station, where would you want to live? Actually, wait, can I incinerate now? I wanted to incinerate garbage. Oh, there we go. That is something I wanted to do. So that is something that we're definitely gonna do. We're gonna put it right there, and we're gonna start to empty this. And where, you may ask? Well, to the incinerator. I want to make sure it works. There we go. And now it will start emptying, and hopefully here. There we go. So. Well, I guess we could put the bus station somewhere around here. I don't want to screw up, guys. Screwing up in this mode is too tough. Too tough for me. We are gonna... go straight. No, actually. Straight? What is that? We're gonna go this way. And then we're gonna go straight. Fancy. Fancy straight. Then... gonna lay down the bus station somewhere around here, and hopefully this doesn't kill us. And time to lay down our first route in the city. So we're gonna open up. Oh damn, really? You're fine, don't complain. All right, so we're gonna